Cytoskeleton is the skeleton of living cells. A key component of cytoskeleton is a protein called actin. Actin monomers come together to form actin filaments. These filaments can then apply force and help cells move forward. Actin dynamics are controlled by a large number of proteins that either bind the sides of the filaments or their ends. To study these molecular reactions, we use a combination of high-resolution microscopy and microfluidics. Using a microfluidic flow cell, we can simultaneously observe the dynamics of hundreds of actin filaments aligned in the flow. High throughput and ease of data analysis are a huge advantage over traditional approaches where filaments randomly grow on a surface. Microfluidics also enables rapid change of biochemical environment by changing the input flow. As an example, microfluidics has been used here to observe the growth and shrinkage of actin filaments, blocking of growth by a capper, and disassembly of actin filaments by a disassembling protein. We are now using this system to study coordinated dynamics of actin and microtubule cytoskeletal systems. So far, these systems have mostly been studied one at a time. In cells, however, actin and microtubules function in a coordinated fashion. These systems also display characteristic mechanical properties. Actin filaments, for example, are thinner than microtubules and exhibit much lower stiffness and persistence length. Together, they endow cells with hybrid mechanical properties, such that the whole is greater than the sum of individual parts. Our goal is to distill the physical principles involved by recapitulating their dynamics using synthetic biomimetic systems. Such a study requires diverse expertise coming together, and our MRSEC-supported work spans between the Geddes lab in the biochemistry department, the Goode lab in the biology department, and the Condev lab at the physics department. Thank you.